We hit it intense, as you know, and the two dogs came out today. I think with the range of motion, yeah, when you come down here, I think you have to stop. You have to be controlled and stop here. You can't, you can't be trying to bounce it on the chest and bring it past here, you know?
That's a good one.
That's overstretch. That might be overstretching.
You don't need to stretch too much for the chest, right?
No,
it's good. It's not worth risking it.
Never.
There you go.
Never, and it's never worth risking. It's never worth risking. You gotta understand too, like, man, in bodybuilding, and I'll just talk to them for a second. In bodybuilding, guys, it's like paramount that you stay healthy. Don't be tearing stuff, pulling stuff. Because what is that gonna do? That's going to alter the way your muscle looks when it heals. Then it's gonna, this is an aesthetic business. We're not lifting weights on stage. Aesthetics is everything. How we look, how smooth the muscle connects to the necks, how conditioned we are, how developed the muscle is. And if you tear something, okay, that's going to alter the way the muscle looks in balance and symmetry to the next, and then game over. There's been a lot of careers in bodybuilding where it's been game over because they tore pecs, they tore biceps, they tore quads, they tore lats. And then when you're up there posing, it exposes. When you're so lean, it exposes the area, the muscle that's off balance and that's torn and that's not repaired and doesn't look in symmetry to the next one.
Good. Come on. Good. Good.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah. Oh yeah. That opened it up.
Yeah.
Two. That opened it up.
Woo! Still 24.
We're gonna go three.
Okay. Yeah.
You're gonna go three.
No. Seven. Left shoulder, baby. Left shoulder. Come on. Good. Come on now. Come on. Come on. Good. One more. Right there. Come on. Come on. Come on. Be careful now. Be careful. Good.
Three.
Four. Five. Come on, baby. Let's go. Six. Good. Seven.
Got one more.
Come on. Control. Left shoulder. Left shoulder.
Nice. Guys, take advantage of when you have a spotter, man. Get more reps in there as you have that spotter. Get more reps in there. Put that extra muscle on. You know, put that extra 3D wow factor muscle on. Take advantage of that spotter when you have it. And also, if you don't have a spotter, I'm a fan of like half reps.
Partial reps, yes.
Partial reps.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, partial reps. It's really good, guys. As long as you can control, don't get out of control, because then you could tear something, okay? But as long as you can control and get those half reps in, more reps, you're all to the good.
Yep.
Yep. Yeah.
Oh man, I feel a lot better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And some people on the spot, they like the wrist or the elbow.
What do you think is better?
I like the elbow because when it's too close to where I'm gripping, you know, it can mess with the, you know, my grip.
Got it.
And then you got to be careful when you're spotting, guys. Don't press them too hard. Let them go with their own momentum. Okay. Because when you press them too hard, you're going against their own motion and the motion that they're used to already with the reps.
Right.
And then they can get, got to be careful because this is an unstable movement, so they can get unstable and then the weight can fall. That's happened to me before.
Mm.
So very gently with their own motion, try to go straight up. Don't come right in between here because you lose your strength inside here with the bench press. Mm. You hold it here. So let them do that themselves if they want to go in.
Oh,
you don't press like this, press straight up.
That's a very good tip.
When you have when you're on a bench, or when you're on, when you have a headrest, you know, for your exercise, you always want to keep your head on the pad and relaxed, and not up and stressed. Neck is stressed. Back of the neck is stressed. Back of the head stressed. Upper, you know, traps are stressed, because you don't want to put the emphasis there and the stress there. Rather, to put it on the keep it on the muscle that you're trying to work. Also, even when you're doing an exercise doesn't have a pad or doesn't have a headrest, try to keep a neutral neck, neutral shoulders, to prevent from injury.
Right. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, okay.
10.
Okay.
Here we go.
1, 2, come on. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, come on. 8, 9, 10. Good, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's a good one. Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
You like the grip?
I like the grip. It's good.
Can you split the number?
Yes. 13, 14, 15, 16. 17, wow, 18, 19, wow, look at him, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 28, 29, 30, 31, wow, wow,
shit,
wow, grand finale.
What?
Like no other. Man, he put me to the test, isn't he? Isn't he? He cannot outwork me. We already said that. Okay, so here we go. Easy. Ah! Wow, here we go. We got bottoms.
Bottoms.
We got bottoms. Come on. Something like that. Something like that.
You got it.
Let's go.
Ready?
Yep. Yeah, again, very important, guys, to relax your shoulders when you're doing these, right? To keep the stress down here, not up here on the neck and on the traps and on the shoulders. Stress down here, baby. Right here. Okay, so that's all she wrote for the chest, guys. And we hit it hard. We hit it intense, as you know. And the two dogs came out today. So go grab your inner dog. Guys, love you guys for following me, for taking a run with me on this journey here. And until the next video, love y'all. Out of here.